Alright, hello. So, I'm going to be making another lantern today. Out of scrap parts. I ripped apart some solar lights already. I got, let's see here. Solar panel. Solar controller board. And we got some little cool LED lights here. These little filament lights. And, let's see here. I got myself a battery compartment. One of the last electronics components you can still get it. Radio shack, or the source. And we got our batteries right here, some wire, blah blah blah. And of course the piece de resistance. The lantern. Now this lantern here was procured from one of my friends, who shall remain unnamed, but he does scrap. And he gets a lot of scrap. And some Richie Pants threw this lantern in the garbage, and it's perfectly good. It's lost some of its little pretty broken glass shards, but that doesn't matter. It just adds character to something like this. Oh, let me turn off the air conditioner. Alright, so first things first, let's put this aside. Let's get rid of my computer mouse because I don't think I'll be doing any computer work. There we go. Alright, the soldering iron's warming up. Power supply on. Now, first things first, we've already got our battery holder. We've got our two nickel metal hydride batteries. And this needs to be stripped. This needs to be prepped. So first things first, let's get into these little lights here. They're pretty. Now you have to be careful when you unwind these, because as I found out previously, you can kick these wires really, really easily. By the way, I apologize. I've got a wretched cold. So yeah. Alright. Now, these lights I ordered on eBay, and they cost me a huge amount of money. I mean, I spent $3 on a set of three. There we go. So, let's go. Yeah! There. So let's turn them on, first of all. And, let's see here. I'm going to grab my power supply. Make sure it's set to 3 volts. And, here we go. Let's, turn off the light here. And we shall test them out. And you can see how pretty they are. Pretty, pretty orange lights. Gonna make a liar out of me. Oh, that's because I'm half retarded. Not that I'm politically incorrect at all. I mean, yeah, there you go. So, as you can see, they're pretty, pretty little orange lights. And they will look very lovely once I put them inside of here. Yes. Alright. That being said, let's get down to the meat and potatoes of the situation. So, I'm grabbing my X-Acto knife. And I'm grabbing my red Sharpie, and let us cannibalize this beautiful set of lights. So first things first, I am going to cut this heat shrink. There we go. There's part of it. Now, if I end up cutting myself, I'll probably get more YouTube views. But I'm going to try not to. Because I don't like my blood all over my static mat. Alright, so there we go. We got that open now. Ah, what have I done? You know what? I'm just going to... Yep, bugger. There. Okay, so now we have exposed the wires. Cool. Now, these things are a pain in the butt to re-solder because this thin, thin wire has an enamel on it. So rather than have to re-solder it, I'm just going to desolder it. So let's grab the old multimeter. Set it for 20 volts because we're working with around 3 volts-ish. I'm just going to guess that's positive and that's negative. And we've got 1.95 volts. Okay, so we know which one's positive now. It's this side. So I'm going to mark that positive. Blood red. Okay, that's done. Now I can put away this scary, dangerous scalpel knife. Alright. So, let us cannibalize these pretty little lights. I should probably... Yeah. For the viewers at home, please don't use your jeans to clean the tip of your soldering iron. That's a bad habit of mine. Okay. So there we go. We've got our leads. This... garbage. Okay, so, let's put those aside for a minute. Now this little guy here, I scavenged from some 3-volt beautiful solar lights, and this panel came from the same solar lights. Yes. Alright, so as you can see, I cut the battery leads off, mainly because I wanted to leave them on there, so I realized it was a 3-volt controller. Alright, so let's get my helping hand out here. I don't need you. Okay, so we are going to need a set of pliers. Here we go. Let's get rid of these little... There. One. Oh, I love the solder smell of lead. I'm sure one day that'll shoot me in the foot when I get cancer or Alzheimer's or dementia, whatever you get from exposing yourself to lead dust. Just gonna clean that off a little bit. Okay, there we go. Okay, so that's that. Now we need to get rid of these little wires where the LEDs used to be. So I'm just gonna throw caution to the wind here and burn my fingers. There. Wires. Gone. Now, that's the solar input right there. And as you can see, I cut the wires kind of short because I'm dumb. So I'm going to need the helping hand again. So, I'm going to use... I'll just use this again. Let's see here. Shaking hands because my blood sugar is screwed right now because I haven't been eating properly. It's kind of a bad thing when you're sick. There's one wire. There's another wire. Boop. Alright, let's clean that up. Free up the vias a little bit. Right. There, the vias are freed up on there. And let's free up the set of vias on here. I don't know how, but I just got solder in my mouth. That's probably a really bad thing. Okay. There, circuit board's freed up. I'll get my helping hand back. Okay, so now, I don't know what that's doing here. Let's go into the bucket of batteries. Okay, so, first of all, let's attach this. Let's see here. I think that's the right way. I always get these things mixed up. I'm so bad for that. Somebody would actually just label this plus and minus. I didn't have to guess all the time. But when you're scavenging components and custom-made circuit boards, you gotta deal with what you get. There we go. Okay, cool. That answers that question. So, thank you again, Bench Power Supply. Let us solder our little wires on here. So I'm going to stick these into these LED markers. If you want to laugh at me for not remembering my diode polarity thingy, go for it. There we go. Alright, we need some solder. Kill me now. Oh, I'm so sick. Okay, so let's get this, I'm just gonna retin this. There we go. We'll throw a little bit of solder on there. Yes, I use flux. I like flux. Flux makes everything so pretty, and you always know that it adheres well. Alright, I'm gonna get my toenail clippers here. And, trim these guys off. See, the whole board should have been trimmed, but nobody ever trimmed the frickin' legs off of these components. There. It's a hell of a lot tidier. Alright. Okay, let's test that again. Alright, battery plus. Battery minus. They're on. Excellent. Okay, here's the first step. Second step. Get this nifty little battery case. Getting technical here. There. I really need some brandy. Ugh, I feel like crap. Okay, so let's load this battery compartment. I'm sure I'm going to get some comments about the fact that I loaded it before I soldered it. Who cares? It's got an on and off switch. Alright, there we go. It is off. Okay. So, next step. Let's load up our negative first, because proper practice says, oh, you should always hook up negative first, because if you don't, the world will come to a crashing end. There. Okay, let's get some solder on that. Clean the tip here, retin. Get a little blob of solder. See, beautiful. Who says I suck at soldering? Not me. Actually, I don't think anybody said I suck at soldering, but I'm not that great. I'm not that bad. Well, at least I'll say that. I'm trying to be humble here. Okay. Solder. There we go. Beautiful. As you can see, nice. Okay, so. That's done. Well, just as a test. There we go. I flicked on the battery pack, and the lights come on. Look, we got two switches. Make things confusing if you don't know what's going on. I should probably eliminate one of these switches. How hard would it be to take this one out? Ah, bugger it. That would be a pain in the arse. Okay, so we've got our pretty little lights. I'm gonna leave them on for a minute. Alright, next part, I need that. Where the hell did I put that solar panel? My spatula. Ah, there it is. Alright, so this guy's nice. It's labeled positive, negative, plus, minus. And with my new bench lights, I thought that these LEDs would be powerful enough to drive these solar panels, but apparently not. They're just not the right spectrum. Okay, so, we got a little bit of wire here. Now, the reason why I'm extending these panels, originally what I wanted to do was cut off the welds around here, take the cap off, and mount the panel on the top of the bell jar. But my friend who I'm making them for really, really likes them the way they are, so I've decided to just make the solar panels long. The other thing she said as well was that she likes the idea of being able to put the solar panels somewhere out of the way, because the jar itself will be in a shaded spot, so she wants to be able to, you know, have them in that shaded spot and have them charge at the same time. So, Let's flick this. Okay, so, this has always been something that, is a controversy, so maybe in the comments you can let me know what's the best way to do this, but, you know, I like to use the white as positive, whereas, it's hit and miss. Sometimes they use white for positive, sometimes they use white for negative. Alright, here we go. Flux you. Alright. So now that's done. Now, something I like to do before I move on to the next step is I always like to give my work a good scrub. And there's my toothbrush. Okay. You see, if you put a little bit of isopropanol onto your project and give it a little scrub, you get all the flux off. Now, I like to get rid of the flux because, you know, it's just good practice. Now, because this isn't going to have a proper base for this, I haven't quite figured out that part of the process yet. I'm just going to put some hot snot on it. Yes, I'm using a lighter. Why? Because I think the hot glue works amazing with a lighter. I'm going to hot glue this so that it doesn't break off. There we go. This lighter is dead. Huh. I've got another lighter. There we go. Now, not only am I going to glue the wires, but I'm also going to coat... here. I'm going to glue the wires well, but I'm also going to put a little bit of dab over top of the terminals on this solar panel so as to protect them from becoming shorted if somebody accidentally puts them on metal or something, because, you know, that's dumb if you short it out. And, I mean, obviously my design isn't the greatest, so whatever. Okay, so I want to give this about... yeah, it should be good. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so let's snip that. Boop! Alright. Okay. Let us separate the wires. Okay, there we go. Need that. And strip them. I sure hope this is a heavy enough gauge for this solar panel. I wouldn't want the wire to melt. Well, God knows. I mean, I think the panel is actually, I think I measured it out to 4.5 volts open circuit at, I think it was like something ridiculous, like 0.005 milliamps or something. It was just tiny. I mean, it just puts out enough battery, or enough power to trickle charge whatever battery you've got it connected to. Alright, so. Of course, this is flex core solder, so I don't necessarily need to flex everything I do, I just prefer to. There we go. Now, I am going to cut these guys a little bit shorter. Okay, so now, let us attach this. Now, the solar panel inputs, they are kind of labeled on here, which is good. Good for Sarah. Oh, this VS is a little bit plugged up. Okay, let's do the step. There we go. Okay, so, yes. Oh. Have it on the right way? Yes, I do. Okay, so now, let us... yeah, I definitely need to put some flux on there. There we go. Beautiful soldering job. I do say so myself. You can see the solar panel's dimming down. Now, there you go. Yeah, that's right, sorry. This light, these lights just aren't the right spectrum for the solar panel to trigger. But I do know what does have the right spectrum. If you'll hold on for a second. My stupid powerful flashlight. There we go. No light. Got light. No light. Got light. No light. Got light. So you're kind of finicky around this. It's just... see? It works fine. It dims it a little bit. That flashlight definitely kills it. Ha! Okay, so now, we're not done yet. I'm gonna get all the flux off the board. There go. Nice and clean, as you can see. It's just... I don't know why, but it makes me insane when people don't clean the flux off the board. I'm going to kill the battery on this temporarily. Alright, so that board should be... I'm just going to run the lighter across it to get the rest of the alcohol off of it. Okay, now, to protect the board, I am going to apply some of this cheap nail gloss. But first, I am going to fasten the board to this battery back. And that will also protect half the battery, or half the circuit board. This is just turning into a horrible mess, isn't it? Okay, so once again, we need some glue. I'm going to just flip this over. Some hot snot. Yay, I said it. That should be enough heat. I'm just gonna juice the back of this thing up nicely. There we go. And now I'm going to adhere it to the top of the AA battery pack. Woohoo! Alright, let's hold that down for a minute so it adheres. Okay, that's just about dry. So, one thing I'd like to do. Yes, as I said, I like to use acrylic enamel. Doesn't matter the source, if it's self-catalyzed or what, but this thing's going to be outdoors, where it's probably going to get wet. So let's just coat some of the electronics on here so that they don't get wet and corrode, because they like to do that for some strange reason. Gotta be careful with the switch, by the way, because it will wick. And if it wicks, it will get onto the contacts of the switch. And if it does that, you will have a really brutal time fixing that switch so it'll work again. And it will involve acetone. Okay, oh. I'll get some of that off. Just for consistency. There. Okay. It'll dry on its own. Let's sort this mess out. Whoa. 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 Question is, does it still work? Yes, it still works. Woohoo! Okay, so now, let us toss aside everything else. Lights off. Lights off. Okay. Enough of that. We are about to stuff the turkey. This is originally designed for a candle. But candles are pretty. They have their place. And this isn't a place for candles. This is a place for fairy lights. So that it will look all sparkly and decorative and pretentious. Just gonna feed these in here. Alright, the last thing in will be the battery. Now, I usually just sit the battery in here, because if you ever have to service it and change the batteries in it, you want to be able to access it. I honestly haven't found a better way of doing it, but this is just a little arts and crafts project, right? Screw the bottom back on. And let me turn the lights off. Woohoo! Doesn't that look splendid? Isn't that pretty? Let me just look at the viewfinder and see if I can actually see that. Yes! You can see it. Epic. And once again, lights go on, lights go off. High intensity flashlight. Well, you don't get the full effect, but you get the idea anyway. So, yeah, that's that. That's all that there is to it. So yeah, again, in the sunlight, this thing will work properly. Basically, the design of the circuit is that if it sees enough power coming in from... It's kind of like a reverse function of a FET. So what it's going to do is sunlight hits this, tells the circuit to power off, and routes all the power from the panel into the batteries. As soon as this thing goes dark, the lights will resume. They will go to full. It's kind of stuck in the middle right now because it hasn't gotten proper light yet. But whatever, it works. All right, so that's that. I'm just going to turn it off and put it aside because, it's going to go out in the sun now and charge and wait for next year when my friend gets back up here and she can enjoy the beauty of this. Oh, there's more glass falling off. Lovely. All right. Thank you, everybody. And I guess in my next video, I'm going to show you guys some Ubiquiti and MikroTik equipment opened up. I'm going to pay some homage to one of my favorite YouTubers, BigClives, and I'm going to rip apart some stuff for you. I will put the link to BigClives' YouTube channel in the bottom. Yes. Thanks for watching.